Hi everybody. Vitaly Sokolov is with you. In this video, we will learn how to download, install and uninstall GL Engine 2D in Borland Delphi 7 and Embarcadero Delphi 10.4 programming environments and, as a bonus, show how such non-visual libraries are added to Lazarus IDE. This engine is easy for beginners, as it has a low entry threshold. And before we start, subscribe to the channel, give this video a thumbs up and write a comment. Also support the channel financially if you want the channel to continue and the videos can remain with free access. Thank you all in advance. In order to download this graphics engine, enter its name in the browser search bar. Go to the GitHub site. Next, click on the code button, select download zip from the drop-down list. If the download has started, then everything is fine. And if you get an error, then you need to turn on the VPN and try again. VPN can be as a standalone program or as a browser extension, or you can use the Tor browser. But keep in mind that free VPN services may collect information about you and then distribute it at their discretion. Therefore, use only paid or trusted VPNs. After downloading, you need to open the archive with an archiver program that is convenient for you, for example, WinRAR, WinZip, 7-Zip and the like. From the archive, drag the folder to a convenient location on your computer. There are several folders inside the GL Engine 2D folder. The Demos folder contains examples of created games and open source programs. The Fonts folder contains some fonts as images in PNG format. The Screenshots folder contains screenshots, images, of this engine. And the Source folder is the source code and files of the GL Engine 2D itself. It is the source folder that we will try to install in Delphi environments. We'll start with Borland Delphi 7. First, we need to put our graphics engine folder in a convenient location. It is desirable that the path to the folder contains only Latin characters, for example, English. The folder itself can be renamed for convenience. I renamed the source folder to GL Engine 2D. I put the GL Engine 2D folder in the lib folder inside the Delphi 7 folder. Next, launch Delphi and click Tools, Environment Options, go to the Library tab. In the Library Path section, click on the button in the form of three dots. A new window opens, in which you also need to first press the button in the form of three dots, then select the main folder of the engine and all the folders that are inside in turn, and then click on the Add button. Thanks to this, Delphi will know in what ways it will need to look for the necessary modules in the future. When all folders are added, click the OK button. Now you can start working with this engine. To uninstall GL Engine 2D, follow the same steps. Launch Delphi and click Tools, Environment Options, go to the Library tab. In the Library Path section, click on the button in the form of three dots. A new window opens, in which you need to click on the lines that store the paths to the GL Engine 2D, and then click the Delete button. When the lines with this engine are deleted, it can be considered deleted, since Delphi will no longer know about it. But the folder with it will have to be deleted manually. Next, we will perform a similar installation in the Embarcadero Delphi 10.4 environment. I put GL Engine 2D in the lib folder, after creating it, inside the Embarcadero Studio 21.0 folder, but you can store the engine elsewhere. Next, launch Delphi and at the top click Tools, Options, go to the Language, Delphi, Library tab. In the Library Path section, click on the button in the form of three dots. The Directories window opens, in which you first need to press the button in the form of a directory, then select the main folder of the engine and all the folders that are inside in turn, and then click on the Add button. When all folders are added, click the OK button. Now you can start working with this engine. To remove the graphics engine, you need to click Tools, Options again, go to the Language, Delphi, Library tab. In the Library Path section, click on the button in the form of three dots. In the Directories window that opens, click on the lines with GL Engine 2D, and then click the Delete button. When all lines are deleted, you will only have to delete the folder with the engine manually. Finally, I will show you how such non-visual libraries are installed in the Lazarus environment. You also need to put the library folder in a convenient location. Then launch Lazarus and go to the Menu Items Project, Options, Compiler Options, Paths. In the Other Unit File section, you need to click on the button in the form of three dots. And when choosing the necessary folders, add the paths to them. But this method has a big minus. In this way you link only the current project with the engine or library. In other projects, if necessary, these steps will need to be repeated. That's all for me. If this video was useful or interesting to you, put your finger up and write a comment, as well as subscribe to the channel to be in stay tuned for new videos. In the description under the video there are details for financial support of the channel. Your help is very important. Vitaly Sokolov was with you. See you in the next videos.